Hi, this is Matt Saternus for Plugged In Golf. Everybody wants to bomb their drive and pit wedges that spin back. And in this video, the third in our ball flight series where I explain spin, I'm going to give you the information so that you can do both. Let's get plugged in. Spin is a critical part of the game. It's what lets us control our distance, hit wedges and short irons that check up, and hit drives that carry forever. So what is it that causes spin? We need to understand that. There are three ingredients to creating spin. You need speed, you need friction, and you need spin loft. Now the first one, speed, is easy to understand. More speed, more spin. Now friction, we'll get into that in a little bit, but what we want to start off with is spin loft. So let's go ahead and first define what spin loft is. Spin loft is dynamic loft minus angle of attack. Let's define those two terms. Dynamic loft is the loft at impact. So this is a 56 degree wedge, but at impact, it could have maybe 45 degrees of loft. I could open it up and it could have 80 degrees of loft. Whatever the loft is at impact is the dynamic loft. Now the angle of attack is the angle that that club is coming into the ground. So that club could be coming down very steeply. It could be coming in very shallow. So the spin loft is the difference between those two. It's basically this gap here. So let's say for this shot, just to make up some numbers, I've got a dynamic loft of about 45 degrees and I'm hitting down about 5. So 45 degrees minus negative 5, because hitting down is negative, is a spin loft of 50 degrees. And if I wanted to make that spin loft bigger, I could hit down more. I could say hit down 10 degrees, or I could add more dynamic loft. Or of course, if I wanted to shrink my spin loft, have it spin less, I could take loft off the club or I could hit down less. Or if I had a driver put the ball on a tee, I could even hit up. Now, before anybody tries to hit a shot with a load of dynamic loft and banging down on the golf ball, let me throw a quick caveat in there. The maximum spin loft you want to have maximum spin is 45 degrees. Why is that? It's because of the third ingredient in spin. Remember, we said we need speed, spin loft, and friction. And if we get the spin loft over 45 degrees, we lose friction and lose spin. So if you want to hit a shot with maximum spin, you need to find a way to make your spin loft 45 degrees. That's why for a lot of players, they're going to get more spin out of a pitching wedge or a gap wedge, maybe even a 9-iron, than they will out of their lob wedge. Because you think about a 60 degree lob wedge, trying to get 15 degrees of forward shaft lean on that is really tough. So don't just assume that your most lofted club is the one that's going to spin the most. So for hitting wedges that really spin a lot, wedges that are going to suck back, remember, we're going to want to think about using our gap wedge or our pitching wedge and hitting down just a little bit, just enough to get a good clean strike on the ball. We don't want to have this idea that banging down on the ball is what makes it spin a lot, because remember, that's going to get our spin loft way bigger than 45 and we're going to lose spin. Now to hit really long drives, we want the opposite. We want less spin loft. Now, again, quick caveat, we need some spin to keep the ball in the air. And the less speed you have, the more spin loft you need to keep the ball in the air longer. But all other things being equal, we want to put that ball up on a pretty nice tall tee. We'd actually like to be hitting up a little bit on it, and we want to keep that loft relatively minimal. We don't need to have that handle leaned all the way forward, but we also don't want to have the club way back here. So just a normal 10, 12 degrees of loft, dynamic loft, and a small upward strike is going to minimize the spin loft on your driver and get you to hit it further. If you have any questions about spin, please post them down below and I'll be happy to answer them. And definitely check out the articles over on pluggedingolf.com and the other videos in this series to understand even more about ball flight. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can also follow us on Twitter, like us on Facebook, and check out pluggedingolf.com. This has been Matt Saturnus. Thanks for watching.